Hello and welcome to iBluairJgR Gaming for Comedy. This is Uncut XCOM 2. It's just you, me, some gameplay, and of course, Dr. Tigan is joining us for now, but soon the rest of my soldiers are going to join us as well. Right now what we're doing is we're taking a look at the geoscape, and what the geoscape is, if you've never played XCOM before, it's a map of the world and all of the different crazy stuff that's going on in the world, right? And it's a big part of the game, right? So every time before you choose a mission, you have to fiddle around with the geoscape a little bit. And while you're fiddling around with it, you've got a lot of options, right? So the idea for XCOM 2 is you are taking on the role of the resistance commander, and you're setting up stuff all over the world, right? You're setting up radio towers and making contact with resistance cells. It's really cool, and you're flying in this big ass ship, like, kind of. You're just sort of telling it where to fly, and then you see it fly in the little picture and stuff, but it's still cool. So you're playing the role as the resistance commander. And as you fly around, different events pop up, and those events give you different things. And you get to choose whether or not you take those events and or ignore them or what have you. So it's very dynamic. You get to sort of pick and choose what you do, and everything has pros and cons, right? Sometimes you pick something and it's like, hey, we found a supply raid and this stuff, and you're like, yeah, I'm obviously going to do that because I want the stuff. So let's mosey on back down to the tip, to the southern tip of Africa, and get to that supply rate. Other times you see something and it's like, eh, I'm not gonna do it. But this time we're gonna do it. And here we go. We're getting in the squad. We got my girl, Fire Girl Jane Kelly. She doesn't have a nickname yet, but that's okay. She's wearing all red now. She's been customized a little bit. So, and she is a ranger. We've also got a second ranger. And last but not least, we have two rookies on our squad. Unfortunately, everybody else is wounded. Everybody else has been getting shot up real bad. Brian Arnold, he's on the bench for now. He got shot up in the last mission, you remember, with the Pink Hulk. If you don't remember, then, you know, you can go watch that if you want to. You don't have to, though. It's not necessary. But either way, so we're going in with two Rangers and two rookies. This is probably the most unideal setup I have ever played with in XCOM. But that is sort of part of the XCOM experience. A lot of times, especially in the early game, you go in with a setup that is not ideal. But before we get in there, let's listen to what Central has to say about the mission.
Resistance operatives disabled an advent convoy in this region, and they sent word for us to come in and seize whatever we can. This is the perfect opportunity for us to recover some of their gear. We'll need to secure the AO and neutralize any hostiles still in the area if we're going to get anything of use out of there.
Okay, so that's a pretty simple mission. There is a downed objective, and it is our job to kill up all the bad guys that are running around, causing a muck next to that downed objective. It's simple. It's really simple. It's pretty, honestly, this particular mission, you're not doing anything special. You're just looking for advent soldiers, and you're killing them up. So, let's get to work, and we're starting off concealed, so that's always nice. We get that little element of surprise. Now, when I first started this mission, I wasn't really sure what to do, so I ended up messing around with the camera for like 3 minutes or something. I was looking for a specific objective, but there is no specific objective in this mission besides kill all the advent troopers. And that's actually kind of cool. As you can see, I'm still looking for the objective. Look, where is it? I can't find it. I'm an idiot. That's why. I'm an idiot. I didn't see in the top left hand corner of the screen, it tells you exactly what you're supposed to be doing, and there's no specific objective, right? It's just kill everybody, right? And that's another thing that's really nice about XCOM. There is variety in the missions. Some of them do feel a little similar. Okay, hey, get to this objective and hack it. Hey, get to this objective and kill it. Get to this objective and defend it. Yeah, there's a little bit of repetition, but they're all different enough, and they all feel different enough so that it doesn't really get boring. And on top of that, everything's always the maps are slightly procedurally generated. Except for some of the story missions and things, so everything's always a little bit different. So, two rangers and two rookies. It's a tricky situation, because the rookies don't really do anything special, right? And the rangers that I have with me, they're not really special either, because they're very low rank. So essentially, Jane Kelly, despite her very fancy red costume that she's got going on right now, red armor, she's pretty much just a rookie with a shotgun and a sword. And that sounds like a lot. It sounds like she's got a bunch of cool things with her. But she's not that much different than the rookies. So it's going to be a tough mission. Simply because I don't have a lot of skills at my disposal. As you level up your soldiers, they get more skills, they get more accuracy, and you know, a whole bunch of stuff. And then depending on how you set up your team, they can work together with one another to do some really cool stuff. But right now, these are just the scrubs. These are the scrubs. And that's part of the reason this particular video, this episode of Uncut XCOM, is called The Expendables. Because those two rookies... It hurts for me to say this, but their life doesn't matter to me. The only person that really matters to me in this mission is Jane Kelly and Saphira Cece. I don't even know if I'm saying that right. I still haven't customized any of my soldiers' names at all. And wait a minute, looks like I'm about to start things off with a bang. Once again, I'm doing a post-game commentary. I haven't watched this over completely. Almost threw a grenade on myself. That would have been terrible. But here we go. Taking that opening shot. Boom. Right in the chest. But he's still alive because he's a tough guy. He's a tough little cookie. But he took some big damage. Okay. Yeah. They didn't find us. We found them and we shot them in the back. And, you know. But that's fine. That's fine. But yeah. So when I go on missions, when I bring a rookie with any one of my main soldiers, the rookie immediately becomes an expendable target. They can die at any point, and I won't feel bad. Okay, I will have no qualms if one of my rookies die. And actually, I actually made a mistake. It's not two rookies. It's only one rookie and someone with a gremlin, which is the specialist. I always want to call them the machinist, but it is a specialist. But either way, she's expendable too, because I don't care about her. It doesn't matter. So... The idea is, when I play with the main characters, which in this case Jane Kelly and Cece, the rookies are basically meat shields. I'm not gonna deliberately try and get them killed. They were in full cover. Well, she was in full cover, but I'm not trying to get them hurt out here. But if there's a situation that pops off where they could die, I'm not going to actively try and save them. I'm going to actively try and save Jane Kelly and Cece. But, you know, it is what it is, folks. It is what it is. Sometimes you got to make the hard decisions. When you're the commander of XCOM, boom, getting that slice off really good. That's one of the cool things about the Ranger class is you are a melee unit as well as a mid-range unit, so it's pretty nice. But when you do go for those big plays with the sword slash, you put yourself in a kind of precarious situation, because right now she's not in cover, so if she gets shot, she's probably gonna die, because that's just how it works. I'm playing on commander difficulty, which means it's very unfair in favor of the computer. They get like RNG favorings and stuff. It's not cool. Now, one thing that I'm not 100% sure about, but I'm pretty sure this is how it works, is those trains are the objectives that we're going to be securing after the mission is over, right? So the more damage it takes, the less supplies I get at the end. I think that's how it works. Not 100% sure. But either way, there's a motherfucking snake slithering around, and that's not good. I do not like the vipers. One of the things that people complain about with the viper is that it pulls people through walls sometimes, and that's just one of the things that happens with XCOM in general, is like sometimes stuff just gets ridiculous and bullets go through walls, and just sometimes the action cam just doesn't look right, and just things don't, not everything is perfect with it, but sometimes you just got to suspend your disbelief, and if you get tongued through the wall by the viper, then just, you know what, just put your hands in the air and say, you know what, that's XCOM. That's what you got to do. That's what you got to do. That's what you got to do for most of the problems that you will experience in this game. And I haven't found that many in my playthroughs. But when you do have problems, especially of the nature of like shooting through walls and missing 99% chances to hit something, just put your hands in the air and be like, you know what, it's over, it's XCOM, and I can't do nothing about it. And that's something you can adopt in your regular life as well. You know, sometimes you just gotta put your hands in the air and say, you know what, it's over. And there we go, getting back into that full cover. That's what you want. You always want full cover. And the reason why is because half cover is no cover. Unless you're hunkered down, then it's a little bit better. But still, half cover, you never want it. Boom, rookie doing some damage, trying to get a promotion, throwing those grenades. I think he actually would have gotten promoted if he killed the target, but, you know, it is what it is. I'm not really concerned with him getting a promotion anyway, because he's a rookie. And rookies don't matter, right? Yeah, here we go. So this guy is flanked. Jane Kelly taking a shot, but shooting straight over his head. Because it's a shotgun, that's one thing that I do miss a little bit from XCOM Enemy Unknown, is the fact that you can't equip assault rifles on the Ranger. Because the Ranger class is... the remade, see, it's over for him. He's poisoned. Wait, before I talk about the Ranger class, he's poisoned and he's got like 2 health left. He's basically dead. Well, he is dead. It's guaranteed that he's gonna die, but he's holding on for dear life right now. He's dodging bullets and everything. He's flanked out and he's not flanked, but he's dodging bullets. It's crazy. This guy, this is very serious. And this is where the Expendables comes into play. He is going to die. There's nothing I can do to save him. He's got 1 health left. He's poisoned. So that means on the next turn, because I didn't bring a med kit with me because I'm an idiot, so on the next turn he is going to die and there's nothing I can do to save him. So what that means is I get to do crazy stuff with him. So as soon as I move this girl, Miss Carrigan over here, I get to move this other guy whose name I don't even remember, but I get to move him into one of the most ridiculous position, any of the most ridiculous spots I can think of, because he's gonna die no matter what I do. You know, it's a kind of a good feeling, actually, you know, because it takes a lot of the pressure off. You know, a lot of times you're thinking, you know, I've still got stuff to lose. But, you know, beware a man with nothing to lose, that's what I always say, you know, because if you've got nothing, then you don't have to be afraid of gambling it away. There you go. That is the most priceless gem that you are ever going to get from this channel until quite possibly the next video that comes out, because the next one could very well be the greatest one. You know, that's what we always strive for, isn't it? You know, you always want the next one to be better. You always want it to be better than the first time, right? But anyway, here we go. So he has a tremendous opportunity to go out guns blazing, moving him straight out into the open. He's gonna die, but he's gonna get that flank. Here we go, taking the shot. Maybe not, holding off a little bit. See, I'm giving you that foreplay now. You don't know if I'm gonna shoot with him first or what have you. I'm gonna give everybody a turn before he gets in. All right, gotta see if I can take that guy out first, but it's gonna miss. You know, because it's the thought process. I want to roll the dice a little bit, get the dice loosened up just to see what's going on. And then after we've exhausted all the other options, then we're going to shoot. So here we go, running in with Jane Kelly, using that sword, but it's not going to finish him off. See, that's not good for me. That is not good for me at all. But here we go. Now it is time. I'm gonna finish him off. See, what I was hoping that was gonna happen in that situation, I was hoping that Jane was gonna finish that guy off with one slice, but she didn't. But if she did, I would have been able to take a shot at the other Advent Trooper with my man that just died and caused the chain reaction of panic. And she almost ran in the poison. That would have been pretty devastating. But yeah, so, you know, you hope for some magic to happen, and it usually doesn't, because that's XCOM for you. And there's also life. XCOM is a beautiful metaphor for the fact that life is completely ridiculous, and here we go. Another snake slithering his way, his and or her way, into the battlefield. You know, I feel like, and this doesn't really mean anything, but I feel like all the snakes look like women. It looks like a female snake. I don't know why I think it looks like a female snake, but I just do. But that's not important. What is important is that we've got to kill that thing, all of those things, before we get tongued or shot or something, because this is not good. Here we go. All things considered, though, we're not doing too bad, considering this is an Expendables mission. There we go. There goes that tongue. And I'm in full cover, so you better not hit me with that. But, you know, when you're doing a mission with Expendables, a.k.a. rookies, a.k.a. low-rank people, when somebody dies, it's sort of expected. Because I went into this mission thinking, okay, he's going to... Those rookies don't matter to me. So it's okay. Oof, girl, you better get behind that rock. I don't know what you're doing poking your head out. You're going to get shot. Okay, but no, seriously, you go... I knew he was gonna die, so I didn't feel bad about it. Which is a stark contrast to how XCOM usually feels. When you start getting to that end game point where you've customized your soldiers a lot, where everybody's got a name and a rank and a whole bunch of skill points and everything, you start to really feel bad when somebody dies. And you don't want, like Brian Arnold, I'm telling you right now, he's one of the main soldiers. I don't want Brian Arnold to ever die. I mean, okay, here's the thing, right? If he dies doing something really cool, then it's okay. But if he just dies on some bullshit, then I'm going to restart a mission. I'm going to tell you straight out. But for, here's the thing with me. When I play XCOM, the only time I save scum is when stuff happens that is completely ludicrous, right? So if I move up one tile and then just everybody just gets killed, then I'm like that could have been bad. That could have been very bad. My heart sank a little bit. Here we go. Oof, there we go. There goes the tongue, and it worked out that time. So you get to see firsthand what the tongue looks like, and this mission is very quickly turning into something I do not want it to be. It is turning into the main people, the non-expendable soldiers, are starting to get injured and potentially are going to die, right? So, okay, so this is a new mechanic. We've never seen this before. I think this is the first time we're actually seeing a snake on an iBluairJgR Game of Comedy video. So let me tell you about what this thing does, right? So if it sticks out that tongue and if it grabs you like this, if it's got you in the grab, every turn you're going to take a little bit of damage. Right, unless you hurt that snake. If you hurt that snake even just a little bit, he's gonna let go, because he's gonna be like, I can't hold this, what the hell. So he let go. So now Jane Kelly is safe and she's got all of her mobility back. But here we go. Obviously we've got options, right? We can try and take the snake out. It's very tempting to just shoot that thing in the face, but if she shoots the snake in the face, she's going to die immediately after that. So I'm gonna move back into cover, but in moving back into cover, I put the snake in full cover. So I that was kind of a bad decision, but it was also kind of a good one because it's saving her life, maybe. So I've got to try and clear. I've got to clean this up, right? I've got to clean it up. We've got the enemy disoriented though from that flashbang, which is a really great item. It's one of my favorite items to bring. It's just great crowd control. And here we go. Here we go. See, this could be grounds for restarting the mission, but we're not going to do it just yet. We're going to see what happens. We're going to see how this plays out. But yeah, the flashbang. There are a lot of... I can't even speak right now because that was beautiful. That snake is dead. Boa constrictor? More like dead a constrictor. That was terrible. But anyway, so there are a lot of different grenade options and secondary item options in XCOM 2. More so than there were in XCOM Enemy Unknown, so I think that's really cool. You get flashbangs, you get little radar discs, and just a whole bunch of stuff. There's so many new mechanics in this game. It's really cool trying to actually figure it out and seeing what stuff works, what stuff doesn't work, and all that. It's nice. But anyway, Expendables. There we go. That was the last Expendable soldier. So now it's up to Jane and Safra. They've got to pull it together. But it looks like they're falling apart. She's gonna panic, and she's gonna... Panic is a funny thing, right? Because when a soldier panics in XCOM, they can potentially move into a new position and take a shot. or they can do what Saffra just did and move into a new position and take cover. So it has its pros and cons, right? Sometimes you shoot somebody with a shotgun and they don't take any damage. Yeah, okay. It's like 10 feet away from me. Yeah, sure. Sure. Okay, so down to the wire, and we've got Saffra panicking. We've got Jane getting flanked. Pulling a little bit of Matrix, though. Ducking and diving under bullets and stuff, even though she's flanked. And she's not looking at him either, so there's just a lot of good stuff going on right now. This guy's going to overwatch instead of taking a shot, which is potentially good for me. The panic is wearing off. So things are turning around a little bit. Now, am I going to make the mistake and move during the overwatch? Not this time. I'm going to take the shot, and I'm going to kill that son of a bitch trying to get me caught up. Because so many times I forget that when enemies go on overwatch, because I just think, oh, he's on overwatch, okay, whatever. Because there's this feeling for me, if they don't take a shot at me, then they basically didn't do anything with their turn, but that's not how it works, right? They can take a shot at you, and they can not take a shot at you and still do something very, very important. But here we go, getting that flank, getting that critical, that's what I'm talking about, cleaning up the rest of the crop. Enemy down indeed, and
status confirmed. All hostiles are down and the area is secure.
Central just told us that the area is secure, but we didn't do that well. Two soldiers died. But once again, in my book, I know it says fair, but for me, it was excellent because Jane Kelly survived and so did Cece. Cece or whatever her name is. So I'm happy. I'm happy with the mission results. And that is the grim reality of XCOM, is that even when soldiers die, you can potentially walk away happy for the simple fact that you don't care about no punk-ass rookies that you just got off the shelf. Okay, because I just got those guys off the shelf, and they didn't matter to me. I don't remember their names. I know one of them was Kerrigan, but it's not really important. So we're flying back to the Avenger one last time, or not for the last time, but we're flying back to the Avenger again. The mission is coming to a close. I believe Jane got a promotion, so when we get back, we're gonna see. Here we go. Let's find out. And we gotta do the walk back, because we do the walk off, we gotta do the walk back. Just to see. I like seeing the difference in the soldiers when they come back, right? If they're injured, they walk off that Sky Ranger injured. Look at them, just hurting. I know, girl, I know. I know. I'm gonna give you your promotion though. So here we go. We got the option to choose between Phantom and Blade Master. Phantom is more of the sort of ninja approach, whereas Blade Master is more of the melee combatant approach. Obviously, from Blade Master, you're obviously going to be getting up in close with the blade, doing some extra damage with the blade. And because CC is a ranger as well, I'm just going to give her the opposite one, because you know if they're going to be going on missions together a lot, so they're gonna have to work together. I'm going to want to compliment. I want them to complement each other, right? So she's a Phantom. So I'm going to continue going down that sort of scout, stealth, ninja tree, and I'm going to give her that Shadow Strike, giving her some extra damage, some extra critical chance, and some extra accuracy while she's concealed. It's a really cool tactic. It's a really, really cool tactic. It's a little bit hard to use. I'll tell you that in advance, but it's cool. I like it. But anyway, we are down to the last bit of the video, and I just want to say, before things close out completely, that was tough.
Commander, the ongoing stress of combat can shake up even the best of our soldiers. As long as we keep them healthy, I'm sure they'll recover given time.
And as you can see, it was tough on Jane Kelly as well. She's very scared now. She's gonna have trouble on the next mission she goes on. But either way, in any case, be that as it may, this has been another episode of Uncut XCOM 2. As you know, iBluairJgR, Gaming for Comedy. Thank you for watching. And I'll see you next time. I'm gonna start saying that at the end of every video from now on. I will see you next time.